Hi guys, welcome to the channel. I hope you guys like this video of us traveling from Cape Town to London via Johannesburg and Dubai. Enjoy!
I got this feeling inside my bones. It goes electric wavy when I turn it on.
Our journey started off at Cape Town International Airport. After dropping off our rental, we waved Cape Town goodbye. We started at the domestic lounge before our flight. We had a couple of drinks and we were ready to go. We then boarded our local flight from Cape Town to Joburg. Flight duration, just under 2 hours. 2 hours later, we arrived in Joburg. At this point, all I was thinking about was finding a place where I could enjoy an ice cold beer. My girlfriend, on the other hand...
Do you have a pharmacy?
A pharmacy from where you're standing.
After that complete waste of time, I finally spotted heaven. We met up with our dear friend Pats and soon I was served an ice cold beer. We had a great viewing spot and could see aircrafts taxiing from the terminals. After some good laughs, with me cracking most of the jokes, and a couple of beers later, we were on our way. We had time for one final dance before leaving the country. Gonna check it in about 20 minutes. So yeah, chilling here, passing time. Dubai.
I'm getting off Dubai, connecting to Lisbon.
We're connecting Dubai to London. We then went to go check in our bags and get our Dubai and London boarding passes. After a successful check-in, we headed straight to passport control.
International departures.
We boarded the 777-300ER from Johannesburg to Dubai. Estimated flying time was around 8 hours. We arrived in Dubai right on schedule, and we had a few hours to kill before our connection flight to London. After a few hours, we were again in the air, but this time heading to our final destination, London. Seven hours later, we arrived at London Gatwick Airport. After going through all the security checks and luggage collection, we took the Gatwick Express to London Victoria Station. Once we got there, we bought our Oyster cards, which we were going to need to get around London during our visit. We then went to Camden, our home for the next couple of days. At this point, we were so exhausted from all the traveling, we decided to call it a night. We wanted to wake up fresh and rested so we could explore the city the next day. Our first morning started at the monument, which was built to commemorate the Great Fire of London and celebrate the rebuilding of the city. If you are fit enough to take the 311 steps to the top, then I suggest you do it. Once at the top, you will enjoy a breathtaking 360-degree view of the city. You will also be awarded a certificate of completion, #311. We then made our way to Madison's Restaurant and Bar. To get there, you take the elevator up at the One New Change building. The place has a spectacular roof terrace that is open to the public 7 days a week. We absolutely fell in love with this place. We had our first London drinks and then went to go explore the city. Because we were close by, we decided to go past St. Paul's Cathedral. Unfortunately, we were unable to visit the cathedral that day, but if you do have time, this is a definite must-do. Our next stop was central London's only marina, St. Catherine's Docks. We took a lovely walk along the Thames path to get there. We got to see great views of the city and some historical landmarks on our walk.
Hi guys, so we are going to St. Catherine's Docks. So there's supposed to be a festival happening there, so I'm not pretty sure if it's happening now because the rain. Yay, betrayal vibes.
We continued our walk alongside the River Thames, stopping every few minutes to enjoy the views. St. Catherine's Docks lies on the north bank of the River Thames. immediately downstream of the Tower of London and Tower Bridge. Once we arrived at the boat show, I challenged Gamza to a race. After that cardio workout, we grabbed lunch and spent the day at the boat show. We ended the afternoon at the Sky Garden. The Sky Garden, aka the walkie-talkie, has spectacular views of the capital. Entry is free, but I suggest you make a booking to avoid disappointments. We ended our evening here with food and drinks at the Fenchurch Rooftop Restaurant. The views were picturesque. The next morning, we started with a tour of Tower Bridge. We ignored the info briefing because we thought we'd cross the bridge when we get to it.
So if any of you are Instagram supermodels, that's where you do your photos.
My girlfriend, the Instagram model, went straight for the pictures. This suspension bridge was built in the late 1800s. We ended the tour at the engine rooms and then went to Borough Market. We then met up with our friend Rutendo. Our next stop was Westminster and the Houses of Parliament. We took a walk from Borough Market along the Jubilee Walkway to get there. Due to protests, everything was closed off for tours. We then went to Trafalgar Square, where we met up with our other friends Jihad and Kuda. We then headed off to Piccadilly Circus, right in the heart of the city. We spent some time here catching up with our friends. As the sun started to set, we decided it would be a great night to go out, so we walked down to Piano Works. At 3 a.m., boozed out, we took the tube and called it a night, or morning, I don't know. We tapped out. The morning started at Buckingham Palace. Hungover or not, we arrived in time for the changing of the guard.
It's such a beautiful day in London, you guys. We are at Buckingham Palace. And then we're laying by the grass because it's so packed. And also, I am so tired. I went out with my friends yesterday. Rutendo, Jihad, and Kula. Oh my word, guys, we had so much fun. But today, but yeah, so we're just gonna chill for a little while before we go to Greenwich Park.
Next stop was Blackheath and Greenwich Park. Situated on top of a hill, you will enjoy amazing views across the River Thames and beyond. Greenwich Park is where you find the Royal Observatory, home of the Meridian Line. This is where time all over the world starts, at 0 degrees longitude. All the 24 time zones are counted from this prime meridian line in Greenwich, either east or west of the line. After crossing the line, we went to one of my favorite places in the world, the Astronomy Center and Planetarium. We touched the 4.5 billion year old Gibeon meteorite, which was part of a group of meteorites that fell in our neighboring country of Namibia. After learning so much about space and geography, we decided to leave the southeast of London by boat. This I highly recommend whether you are traveling to or from Greenwich. Refreshments are also available on the boat. This made the journey even more enjoyable. Today we went to go explore a different city, so we went to Paddington Station to buy a train ticket to Bath Spa. This was the first time we were leaving London since we arrived here. The journey was only an hour and a half, and we arrived in the city of Bath 90 minutes later. Visiting the city of Bath was one of the highlights of our trip. Located in the southwest of England, this Roman city has a population of just under 100,000 people. It is one of the most elegant and architecturally distinguished of British cities. We started with a visit at the Roman Baths to learn more about the history of the natural hot springs that the city was founded upon.
Good, thanks, and yourself?
Just press number one, then play.
Thank you. Say hello, honey.
Hello. During the Romans' rule of Britain, this temple and bath complex was constructed in honor of Sulis Minerva, the goddess of healing and wisdom. At the end of the tour, we got to taste the healing springs of hot water. The water is lukewarm and not pleasant to drink, but it might heal all your illnesses, as the legends claim. We continued to explore this lovely city, and we made a stop at one of its most impressive landmarks, the Royal Crescent. Our final stop was Thermae Bath Spa. No cameras are allowed inside, so I will share this.
Welcome to the Thermae Bath Spa, where you can bathe in Britain's only natural, warm, mineral-rich waters, as the Celts and Romans did over 2,000 years ago. You can choose from a range of relaxing spa treatments and enjoy your time relaxing in the spa. We suggest having a shower first on the lower ground floor as you walk through to the indoor Minerva bath.
Today we visit the UK's most popular paid tourist attraction, the London Eye.
Welcome everyone, mind the gap there please.
The London Eye is currently the fourth largest wheel in the world, and it gets over 3.5 million visitors annually. This 135 meter tall wheel provides great views of the city of London, and you can see up to 40 kilometers in all directions. Next, we went to Covent Garden. We also got to visit the popular Jubilee and Apple markets. A trip to London is not complete without visiting the vibrant Soho. We then headed to London Ice Bar, which is a short walk away.
VIP. Let's kick it.
Ice, ice, baby. Ice, ice, baby.
All right, stop.
If you are looking for a unique experience, then you must visit the London Ice Bar. You will be given a thermal cape and gloves for the cold, as the bar is kept at -5 degrees. This is literally the coolest place to visit in the city. A cocktail is included in the price of your ticket, which is a definite plus. Everything in the bar is made of ice, including the cocktail glasses. We enjoyed our ice-cold spirit-based cocktails while admiring the ice sculptures and good music. Our time in London was coming to an end, but we could not leave without visiting the famous Camden Market. We had visited a couple of markets during our visit, including the popular Borough Market and Covent Garden, but Camden Market was by far our favourite. Situated in Camden Town, this market has only been in existence since 1974, and we enjoyed some wonderful meals and drinks. It also made for an interesting shopping experience. We exchanged our currency at Gatwick Airport and then checked in, left the UK, left Dubai, and went back home.